feelings. Nothing more than feeling. Trying to forget my feelings of love.
The primary purpose of marriage is having children and bringing them up for God. The Eastern Orthodox used to believe this. And this concept comes from the Bible, and God blessed them, saying, "Increase and multiply, and fill the earth." And this is supported by St. Justin Martyr. We marry to bring up children, or we do not marry in our continent. The longer catechism of the Eastern Orthodox Church, which was written in 1845, seems to agree the primary purpose of marriage is having children and bringing them up for God. It asks, what is matrimony? Matrimony is a sacrament in which, on the free promise of the man and woman before the priest and the church to be true to each other, their conjugal union is blessed to be an image of Christ's union with the church, and grace is asked for them to live together in godly love and honesty to the procreation and Christian upbringing of the children. For good measure, the Catechism adds, what virtue is there in each of these sacraments? The answer, in matrimony he receives a grace sanctifying the married life and the natural procreation and nurture of children. But over the last 100 years, the Orthodox Church has gradually changed its teachings to allow contraception and abortion. Please refer to my prior videos on those topics. Since the modern Orthodox are permitted to frustrate the purpose of the Marriage Act, it seems inevitable that the modern Orthodox Church would need to change its definition of marriage and the purpose of marriage. And we can see this has occurred on Orthodox Wiki's entry on marriage. The only mention of procreation in the entire article is a misuse of a quote by St. John Chrysostom that procreation is a normal feature of marriage, but not essential to it. The quote very clearly is referring to a marriage of two chaste individuals, consecrated virgins. This type of marriage is obviously an exception and not the norm. But Orthodox Wiki is using that and twisting it to say procreation is an important part of marriage in general. Orthodox Wiki fails to mention that St. John Chrysostom also wrote, "A marriage without the desire for children and the prayer to God to bear and nurture them is contrary to the sacrament of love. This is the true purpose of marriage." In all fairness, the Orthodox Church in America does mention procreation in its article on marriage, but it doesn't do so until it gets all the way down to here. And this suggests that to the modern Orthodox, procreation is no longer the primary purpose of marriage. I suppose we could end the video right here, but there's another paragraph in the Orthodox Church in America's article on marriage that has a lot of really weird stuff, and we should break it down a bit. It says that there is no legalism in the modern Orthodox sacrament of marriage. And that is another way of saying that since the modern Orthodox Church allows divorce, abortion, and contraception in marriage, it rejects the established set of rules handed down by the early church, which were governed by logic. When the modern Orthodox Church rejects legalism, they set themselves free of the constraints imposed by the fathers and the original teachings of the Orthodox Church. The paragraph says that, for the modern Orthodox Church, marriage is not a contract. Please see my recent video on how marriage is not a covenant, and I won't repeat all the material here, but I will note that this is just another modern Orthodox novelty. According to John Mayendorf, in Marriage and Orthodox Perspective, even when Christianity became the prevailing state religion, the ancient definitions of marriage as contract continued to be accepted in state laws, and even in the ecclesiastical Nomo Canon and 14 Titles, which was a collection of Orthodox canon law. It is also found in the Slavic version of the Nomo Canon, the so-called Book of the Rudder, which was the foundation of canon law in Slavic countries until the beginning of the 19th century. If canon law is truth, then the modern Orthodox have set themselves free from truth. With marriage no longer being a contract, it is much easier to go in and out of marriages and to get divorces. The paragraph continues to tell us that like a common law marriage, there are no vows or oaths for the Orthodox. It's sort of like a hippie marriage. The paragraph continues to say that the modern Orthodox marriage is, in essence, the baptizing and confirming of human love in God by Christ and the Holy Spirit. It is the deification of human love in the divine perfection and unity of the eternal kingdom of God as revealed and given to man in the church. This language about the deification of human love seems to be a novelty, but I am having trouble tracing it back to its source. If you are Orthodox and you do know the source, please comment down below. It might have been borrowed from John Calvin's discussions on the deification of love. Calvin's theology changed marriage from a contract to a covenant. Though the Orthodox have echoed the Protestants in saying that marriage isn't a contract, I don't see that the Orthodox are using the word covenant here. However, absent that, everything else seems to fall in line with Calvinism. Calvin decided that marriage could not be a contract because he claimed that no earthly authority could enforce that contract. So he just changed marriage from a contract to a covenant, and God became the enforcer of the covenant, which included the deification of love. Damien Conner wrote, "The use of covenant to describe marriage is wholly inappropriate and nonsensical. A covenant is between God and man, and the consummation of it is the new and eternal covenant in Christ's blood. Marriage is a willing contract and sacrament that dissolves with death." Whether or not this comes from Calvin, the deification of human love seems blasphemous. It is contrary to Scripture. How can human love be like God? Scripture says, "I am God, and there is no other. Who is a God like to thee? There is none among the gods like unto thee, O Lord, and there is none according to thy works." Is the modern Orthodox concept of marriage akin to trying to build a Tower of Babel to rival God? It is, if we take the words of the Orthodox Church in America at face value. Human love is imperfect. It is impossible for it to rival God. When couples end up having rough patches during their marriage, as all marriages do, and they believe in this deification of love stuff, they are bound to be disappointed. Hence, the Orthodox allow up to 3 divorces in violation of divine law. If the deification of love doesn't come from John Calvin, there's only one other source that I know of that claims that human attributes can reach godlike levels, and that concept originated in the Jewish Kabbalah, and that was called the Tree of Sephiroth. The concept was later developed in the heretical Christian Kabbalah. The Tree of Sephiroth proposes that people and human attributes can progress toward deification. Of course, that is all just mumbo jumbo, but please note that the Christian Kabbalah borrows heavily from Plato, and if this is the source of the deification of love, that would be extremely ironic because the Orthodox are always complaining that the great St. Thomas Aquinas quoted from Aristotle. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be back again within a week with another one, but in the meantime, please check out my Facebook page and my Twitter page. Every day I post additional content that you won't find on this YouTube channel, and also, please pray for the church.
Feelings, nothing more than feelings, trying to forget my feelings of love.